Fit Company, makers of those fine Fit products, present the new Fit Bandwagon, starring Alice Faye.
You never know just how much I love you. You never know just how much I care.
And Phil Harris.
Won't you come with me to Alabama? Let's go see my dear old mammy. She's frying eggs and broiling hammy. That sugar-cured hammy. That golden gravied hammy. And that's what I like about the South.
Morning out at the Harris residence. Alice has been up for some time, but the master of the house is just now coming downstairs to join his wife.
Oh, baby, you really look luscious this morning. Look at that peaches and cream complexion and those big brown eyes and that blonde, wavy hair. Oh, you really got it, kid.
Phil, will you stop looking at yourself in that mirror?
Well, can I help it if I'm adorable? Hey, where are the kids?
They're playing outside on the swing. I want to speak to you about them, Phil.
Yeah? What's up?
Well, baby Alice will be starting school next year, and so will Phyllis before long.
Yeah, they are growing up.
I was thinking, it might be a good idea to get them a tutor.
No, honey, they're too little. They're liable to fall off that thing and get hurt.
No, Phil, I mean someone to come in a couple of days a week and get them started on their ABCs.
Oh, I don't know, honey. When I was a kid, I didn't have no fancy teachers coming to my house.
Oh, you didn't have no fancy teachers coming to your house. Well, just where did you acquire your vast education?
What are you asking? I got it off my old man. From the time I was 5 years old, he took me every place he went.
Oh. I suppose he wanted you to see things for yourself, huh?
No, he just didn't like to get loaded alone.
You know that's not true.
It is true. My first words were, draw two.
Yes, and you haven't forgotten them either. But, Phil, this is serious. Emily Williams gave me the name of an excellent tutor. He's done wonders for her boys.
What do you mean? Her kid's 19 and he's still drooling.
Well, anyway, I'm going to have a talk to this man.
Well, I don't think too much of the idea.
But still, you don't want your children to grow up to be ignorant, do you?
Look, what was good enough for their father is good enough for them.
That's just it.
All right, all right. I'll leave it up to you. Look, I got to get out the studio. We got a band rehearsal this morning.
You won't be long, will you?
No, no. I'll be right back after lunch.
All right, goodbye.
Come to think of it, I might be back before lunch.
Harris.
Oh, what is it, Sissy?
Don't you dare leave this house. You haven't had any breakfast yet.
Oh, that's all right, Sissy. I'll grab something down.
No, 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 no. You sit right down here and drink a cup of coffee. I've been keeping it warm for you.
Well, bless you, Sissy. you beautiful creature, you.
Oh, Mr. Harris. You know I'm not beautiful.
What do you mean? I bet if I'd have met you 10 years ago, they'd have had to tie me down.
That's all right, Mr. Harris. 10 years ago, I'd have cut the rope.
Oh, Sissy, you rascal, you. You're sharp as a biscuit this morning. What's that perfume you got on?
Oh, I'm Mr. Harris. I don't use perfume.
Well, something smells awfully good.
Well, I did put a little vanilla extract behind my ear.
Well, you keep it up, honey. After all, Alice got me with a dab of bourbon.
Oh, Mr. Harris, you say the funniest things.
Well, I try. Look, Sissy, thanks for the coffee. I got to get down to rehearsal now.
Oh, Mr. Harris, I wonder if sometime on the radio your band would play a number for me.
Certainly. Be glad to, honey. What is it?
Flow gently. We dance.
Hey, Sissy, Harris playing that one would be like Senator Bilbo singing Yankee Doodle Dandy.
Okay, fellas, put away them racing forms and start the pitch, because here comes your Dixieland just over.
Hey, let's make this one fast, Bill. I gotta get out of here.
What's wrong with you, Artie?
Gotta take my mother-in-law to Anaheim.
What, again? I thought you just took her there last week.
I know. She keeps coming back.
All right. Throw a sock over her head the next time. Get rid of her. Now, let's get going. Hey, wait a minute. Where's Frankie, my guitar player?
I'm over here, Curly, getting a cigarette out of my coat pocket.
Oh, that stuff is so hard to get.
Frankie, get up. You'll get glass in your tongue.
It up, I was just kissing it goodbye.
Never mind. Now, let's get this rehearsal over with.
But, Bill, you didn't pick a number yet.
Okay, well, hand over that file. Let's see what we got.
Okay.
5 minutes more. Swamp Fire. Jelly Roll Blues. Flow Gently Sweet. How did that get in there? Oh, here's a good one. Blue Skies. Hey, fellas, let's give this one the once over. You got it? Okay, now take it from me. One, two. Come on, who's the wise guy in the outfit?
What's the matter, Bill?
What's the matter? One of you bumps is playing the melody.
Oh, but Bill.
What's wrong with you guys? You sound like something that fell off of the Manhattan merry-go-round. I can't get a... Come on, fellas, let's try this number four here, and last time, let's take the lid off of it.
Bill, I gotta take my mother-in-law
in. Ah, shut up. One, two.
If you're ever down in Texas, look me up, look me up. If you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Where the men are men and love it, and the gals are so glad of it. So if you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Everybody's gonna holler, howdy-do, howdy-do. Everybody there will say, howdy-do, howdy-do. Where the men are men and love it, and the girls are so glad of it. If you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Ask anyone for Rusty, everybody knows of me. They'll tell you where I'm riding at, bar A, B, C, or D. So if you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Now we've got everything in Texas looking up, looking up. With the moonlight on the prairie and the gal that ain't contrary. So if you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Ask anyone for Phil Z, they'll tell you where I'm at. They'll say that I'm in Galveston with a box, back coat, and a Stetson hat. So if you're ever down in Texas, look me up, look me up. We've got everything in Texas looking up, looking up. Am I right or Amarillo, man, that takes a chilladilla. So if you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Bronco ride, you take some cactus, or you wind up on the cactus. So if you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Where's the gals are good at figures, and the cowboys quick on triggers. If you're ever down in Texas, look me up. Where every gal's a raven beauty, hip-tie, coyote. What I'm trying to tell you is I can't wait to get back down there so I can hear, sounds like this, that, sure glad you come by. Don't y'all forget to come back now, you hear? Bye now. Bye. I'm gonna build a dopey palace for my Alice down in Dallas. So if you're ever down in Texas, look me up.
Every woman wants her hair to be a shining example of well-groomed beauty and feminine charm. And every woman can have shining, radiantly clean, soft hair by using Fit Dandruff Remover Shampoo. For Fit Shampoo reconditions as it cleanses, making your hair soft and silky, shining with the glowing light of a firefly, and surprisingly easy to manage. Fit's reconditioning action not only helps your hair wave more easily, but helps it keep the wave longer. And remember, Fit Shampoo is good for all colors and textures of hair. Countless discriminating women find Fit Shampoo a real aid to hair beauty. and yet it's so convenient to use. One reason is because it lathers and rinses out equally well in hard or soft water. And since it's completely soluble, only an ordinary water rinse is needed. Fit shampoo is economical, it's efficient. It's a shining example. A shampoo to give your hair well-groomed beauty and feminine charm. For beautiful hair, use Fitch Dandruff Remover Shampoo regularly each week. Fitch is spelled F-I-T-C-H.
Number are you calling? Cleo?
I'll have Encino 8342.
I'm sorry. That's a private number.
I know that. I'm calling Alice Faye.
Is this a person-to-person call?
Well, who do I sound like, a hyena?
Well, now that you mention it.
Never mind. Now, just give me the number, sister.
Here's your party. Hello.
Oh, hello, Alice. I'm leaving the studio, and I'll see you in a few minutes.
Oh, Phil, I'm so glad you called. I got the tutor I was telling you about for the children. He's coming 2 days a week.
Yeah? What's he like?
Well, he's English, and the children are crazy about him already.
English? What is he? One of them snooty mademoiselles?
Not at all. Why, he's charming, Phil.
Wait a minute, Alice. Us with an English tutor, they'll come and get us. They'll stone us. This will ruin me. The white coat man will be there. It's going to ruin my social standing.
Your social standing?
Certainly. It's liable to ruin my reputation as a crumb.
Well, I don't care. You'll be very good with the children. And look, Phil, when you come home, please do me a favor. Try to be a little careful.
What do you mean?
I mean your manners and your grammar. After all, this new tutor seems so nice, and I wouldn't like to lose him the first day.
Now, wait a minute. What's wrong with Harry?
I'll tell you what's wrong with Harry. Limit your call to 5 minutes, Leo.
You get off of here.
Look, Phil, I don't want to criticize you, but please be on your best behavior when you come home.
Listen, honey, you don't need to worry about me. I'll ride in there on an English setter.
Phil.
Goodbye. I'll see you later.
Who is that on the phone, Mommy?
It's your daddy, honey. I was telling him about Mr. Merton, your tutor.
Oh, he's a nice man, Mommy.
Well, I'm awfully happy your children like him.
Why? Is he going to get daddy's place?
Oh, no. No, no. He's just going to give you a few lessons so you and Alice will be all ready for school when the time comes.
But why do we need a tutor? Daddy can teach us about everything.
Oh, because?
Yeah. Our daddy is the smartest, the clever, and the most beautiful man in the whole world.
Why, Phyllis, where did you hear that?
Baby Alice read it to me where Daddy wrote it on the wall.
Oh, and I thought she just rubbed them all off.
Union, that was swell. That's all for today. I'll see you guys Sunday.
Hey, Phil. Hey, Charlie.
What is it, Frankie?
Come over here.
What do you want?
Come up. Got a couple of pictures I want to show you.
Oh, Frankie. Put them away. You're a big boy now.
No, they're just a couple of snapshots of a little cutie I met in Santa Monica. How do you like this one? We're taken down at the beach.
Yeah? How long has she been in the water?
She's a cute kid. Why, she never goes anywhere without her mother.
Yeah?
Of course, the mother will go anywhere.
Oh. Stop that, Frank. How could you? Stop it. You got to stop hanging around that Jack Kirkwood rehearsal.
Well, I like it. Hey, we're having a little party tonight up at Harry's place. Why'd you drop over?
Party? You going to be stag?
Sure, there'll be plenty of dames.
Frank, I've been all over that with you. I've been all through it, Frankie. I can't make it.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Alice
won't let you out.
Well, it ain't that at all. I want to stay home.
I still want to stay home.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? Look, Frankie, when a guy's got butter in the icebox, he don't go out looking for oleo.
Well, you sure have changed, Curly. You ain't the common yard dog Harris I used to know. Remember that time we took the band to Australia?
Yeah, yeah. We ran into a couple of chicks the first night out, huh?
That's right. That's
hey, wait
right.
a minute. Wait a minute. What? Yeah, it's okay. She's not around. Go ahead.
We took the dames dancing?
Yeah.
And those Australian girls really had the joy jumping.
They sure did. I didn't find out until 2 days later that mine was a kangaroo. And I was doing what they call an evermore pitch with a backswing glide. I was Hey, listen, let me ask you something. Frankie, weren't those people in Australia Englishmen?
I don't know. They were some kind of foreigners. Why?
Well, Alice has a new English tutor for the kids, and she don't think I'm sharp enough for the guy.
What do you mean? Meet him on his own ground. Talk his language. You know, God blimey, Governor, it's a bit thick out tonight, ain't it all? Biscuit head?
Hey, Frankie, do them Englishmen really talk like that?
Sure they do.
Well, no wonder them Russians don't understand them.
Come in. Oh, Mr. Merton, I didn't know you went out.
Yes, Sissy, I had to run down to my place for some books. Are the children about?
Yes, I think they're right in the front room. They've been after Mrs. Harris to sing them a song.
Oh, thank you very much. I'll go in.
Stay there if you are a vexed one, a dreary, weary, and perplexed one. I've got troubles and he's got troubles, and you're no better than the next one. You will find your share of bliss if you just remember this. You can't have everything. Be satisfied with the little you may get. You can't have everything. Don't envy neighbors and the fortunes that they get. Live and laugh and listen, don't be greedy. Help the needy and you gotta get lucky, yes indeedy. Man, rich man, beggar or thief, you just can't have everything. So thank your stars above for a song in your heart, a penny in your pocket, and someone in your arms to love. For a song in your heart, a penny in your pocket, and someone in your arms.
That was pretty, Mommy.
Yes, Mrs. Harris, that was excellent. You have a lovely voice.
Oh, Mr. Merton, I didn't see you come in. I was just singing for the children.
Yes. Phyllis and Alice, if you'll just run up to the nursery, I'd like to have a little chat with your mother.
All right, Mr. Merton.
Well, Mrs. Harris, I must say you have two delightful youngsters.
Well, thank you.
They're such attractive little types, and so articulate. Of course, I feel a bit of an outsider in their conversation. For instance, who is this person they continually refer to as Hotshot?
Well, I'm afraid that's the nickname they have for their father.
I see. By the way, Mrs. Harris, just what does your husband do?
Do?
Yes, what is his means of employment?
He's a musician. He's with Benny.
Benny? Benny who?
Jack Benny, you know, on the radio.
Oh, yes, yes. Forgive my ignorance. You see, I seldom listen to the wireless.
Well, you see, Mr. Harris has the office.
Hey, Alice, I'm home.
Oh,
Alice.
Oh, honey, we're in here in the living room. Come on in.
Oh, all right.
Mr. Merton, this is my husband.
Oh, how do you do, sir?
Well, God bless me, Governor. This is a trick out tonight, ain't it, girl?
What say we pop down to Cheapside for a bit of off and off,
I beg your pardon.
Oh, Phil Harris, this is a fine way for you to come home.
Don't stand there, Alice. Throw a spot of tea on the governor. Hey, we got no toasted prawns or crumpets or anything. I say, governor.
I do believe you're pulling my leg.
Oh, not at all, Biscuit Head. I was 2 feet from you.
If you'll excuse me, Mrs. Harris, I believe I'll rejoin the children.
I don't blame you, Mr. Murphy.
So long, Governor. Don't take no wooden tuppences.
Phil Harris, just what was the purpose of that?
What did I do? I didn't say nothing.
Oh, no? Oh, you Biscuit Head. We're off to keep going for a bit of off and off. Don't take no wooden defense.
No wooden defense.
That's a 10th Avenue Englishman if I ever heard. Well, I'm trying to take it. Come on, come double tip. Don't worry. I'm doing all right.
Look, I really laid it on him, didn't I? What are you beeping about? You told me to be refined, didn't you?
You did this on purpose, you big clown. Just because the tutor was my suggestion.
But look, honey, it don't make sense, us with an English tutor.
And why not?
Well, let's face it, kid. You'd still be working at your old job if you hadn't slammed your elevator door on Zanuck's foot.
Bill Harris, you know I was never an elevator operator.
All right, all right. So you dropped one of your fans in his soup. I don't know.
Bill, will you stop being so funny? I only want our children to have the best education we can give them. Besides, it will mean a lot to you.
To me?
Yes. It'll be kind of nice to have someone to read to you in your old age.
Kind of nice right now. All right, honey. Maybe the guy's okay for the kids. I don't know.
Well, after your performance just now, we'll probably never see him again.
All right, I'm sorry.
Well, I think you owe Mr. Merton an apology.
All right, but gee, the fella's an Englishman.
Well, what about it?
What about it? Frankie just told me them guys came over here and burned down the White House.
Phil, that was in 1812.
Well, then why don't they go home? Is the joint still smoking? That's fine.
Never mind that. I want you to speak to Mr. Murphy.
All right. I'll talk to the governor. I'll talk to him.
Excuse me, Mr. Harris.
Ah, Luigi. How's the garden coming along?
Oh, fine, maestro. Maestro, would Mrs. Harris like some flowers in the house for the company?
Company? Oh, no, that's the governor.
Huh?
Oh, no, that's the tutor. Mrs. Harris has him for the children.
Oh, yes. You know, maestro, it's a good thing to bring out the talents of the young. I'm never going to forget when Luigi was a little boy. I want to be the greatest painter the world has ever known.
Hey, I never knew you wanted to be an artist.
Oh, yes. I was determined to emulate Michelangelo and Botticelli. Oh, by the way, maestro, do you like Botticelli?
Yeah. Yeah, it ain't bad if you cut it with a little vermouth.
Well, finally, I went to Paris to study art. I rented a charming little studio on the left bank. Oh, maestro, Paris was beautiful. I would sit by the hour in little sidewalk cafes, sipping the wine from the provinces. And then at night, all the beautiful models would flock to my studio, and we would talk of life and love.
But, Luigi, didn't you do any painting?
Maestro, I asked you with a setup like that, were you?
Don't let me stop you.
But, maestro, I cast aside these little pastimes and I threw myself into my work. For 2 months, I painted like a fury. I painted like a fiend. I painted like a madman. But nobody would buy my work.
Why not?
maestro. They wanted someone who painted like a painter.
You can't please everybody, Luigi. Governor, you can really play this thing. Hey, let me have some more of that.
Oh, well, now, how about...
Oh, excuse me. I wondered who was playing.
Come in, Mommy. Mr. Merton was playing piano for us. Daddy said he's really hip.
Well, that's fine. By the way, Phil, did you talk to Mr. Merton?
Yeah, the governor and me, we're pals now. We got it all ironed out, eh, Gabby?
Oh, yes, indeed, Mrs. Harris. We had tried a discussion on music. You know, I studied a bit of composition myself at the London Conservatory.
And Phil discussed music with you?
Yes, indeed. I learned a great deal on the subject from Mr. Harris.
Now, what could Phil possibly teach you about music?
Just this, my dear. Won't you come with me to Alabama? Let you see my dear old mammy. She's crying eggs and broiling and hammy. And that's what I like about the South. Yeah.
Ah, send me, Governor. You're a solid chap, Governor.
Back in just a moment. You know, folks, first impressions are lasting ones. But you can't make a favorable impression if you have telltale dandruff flakes on your hair and scalp. Don't let dandruff work against you. Use Fitz Dandruff Remover Shampoo. The only shampoo made whose guarantee to remove dandruff with the first application is backed by one of the world's largest insurance firms. You'll be impressed with this easy-to-use and oh-so-effective shampoo. Simply apply a little Fitz shampoo to your scalp and massage while the liquid penetrates the thousands of tiny hair openings on the scalp, dissolving every trace of dandruff. Then add water. A lavish, creamy, rich lather forms to carry away the dissolved dandruff, leaving your scalp tingling with cleanliness, eager to please with its new beauty. Buy a bottle of Fitz shampoo at your drug or toilet goods counter, or have a professional application at your beauty or barber shop. Fitz shampoo will help you make your first impressions on others pleasing and lasting.
Good night, baby.
Yeah, you two better get some sleep now. You had a big day with your new tutor and everything.
Daddy, why aren't you smart like Mr. Merton?
Look, honey, ain't it enough that I'm pretty?
Right, babies, after all.
You can't have everything. Be satisfied with the little you may get. You can't have everything.
Using a few drops of Fitz's ideal hair tonic every day.
This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.